Hi, in today's video I'm gonna show you how to build automatic watering system. This will be the first of hopefully many Arduino projects. If you subscribe for something else, don't worry, I will still post CNC and injection machine videos. Let's get into the project. I hope you like the idea of a machine taking care of your plants. That's what we're gonna do in today's video. We're gonna build a device which will water your plants when you're not there. So let's go. We'll need a few things: soil moisture sensor, Arduino, breadboard, transistor IRLZ44N. Then we will need LCD 16x2 with a I2C interface and pump, 12 volt DC peristaltic pump. But that's not all, you can see whole parts list down in description. I was planning to use Arduino Uno through the first stage of the project, which is a breadboard part, and then switch to Arduino Nano, but later decided to just go with Arduino Nano throughout the project. I have to warn you about one thing. We will use two voltages on one breadboard. One is from a power supply, 12 volt or 9 to 12 volt, and the other is 5 volt from Arduino. Don't mix them up, because you will destroy your Arduino and probably other components as well. To compile our sketch, we'll need a liquid crystal I2C library. To download it, we'll need to go into menu, sketch, then include library and manage libraries. We're gonna search for liquid I2C. We're gonna choose a liquid crystal I2C, then click install. Upload your sketch as usual. Consider using bench power supply for powering your project for the first time with a limited current. That will save you lots of trouble, trust me. Solder 100 nanofarad capacitor to the pump to minimize inductive spikes. Then solder leads to the pump terminals. Then connect tubes, hoses, pipes, or whatever it is called where you live. 1/8 or 3 mm internal diameter will be perfect. Then finally, check if everything works as it should. Okay, it's time to transfer components on perfboard. For enclosure, I will recycle cotton buds box. You can use any similar size box for your project. At first, we will make small board for tacked switches. Just scratch where you want it to break and apply brute force. Solder wires and the board is nearly ready. Trim it a little more and make 3 mm holes. Then main board, enlarge holes for DC socket. I found 2.5 mm drill, perfect for the job. Place all components on the perfboard. Solder them carefully. Pay extra attention to tracks next to each other. It's easy to short them out. That's bottom of the main board. And this is top side. Switchboard, bottom and top view. Mark center of the hole for the peristaltic pump. Drill pilot hole and mark pump cutout. Then very carefully cut required diameter hole. If you never cut plastic with blade, don't try it. Drill holes around instead. Cut bridges and file rest. It's much safer option. Measure and make 3 mm holes. Then do the same with switchboard. As you make the holes to attach board, you can precisely measure where to drill 8mm holes for tacked switches. If you are using different tacked switches, change it accordingly. If you try a sharper drill bit than I've used, you should end up with a much cleaner edges. Then finally, drill 3 holes for DC jack, soil moisture sensor and USB connector. Hot glue LCD in place. Insert your pump. Use 3mm bolt and screw to hold it in place. Connect soil moisture sensor. Pay attention to connect it properly. Connect LCD. And that's it. Just close your box, connect power and enjoy your device. You can tweak Arduino sketch to suit your plant more, your soil type and pot size as well. Device when idle consumes around 70 milliamp at 9 volt and around 300 milliamp when pump is running. I recommend 9 volt power supply, as with 12 volt Arduino regulator is getting quite hot. Make sure you firmly attach tubing to the pot. Last thing you want is a big puddle next to the plant. You can use laundry clips and solid core wire. If you like to watch more videos like this, hit that subscribe button now. If you like the video, please give it thumbs up. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Of use. Oops. Well, they had that was. Oh, psh. Damn it.